thank you all for joining us here. As we commemorate the establishment of ice roads in the Northwest Territories as an event of national historical significance. My name is Jonah Mitchell. I'm the Field Unit Superintendent for Parks Canada for the Southwest Northwest Territories. I'm going to somehow got the short straw here, so I'm the master of ceremonies for today. I'd like to start the ceremony just by welcoming Chief Edward Sangris of the Yellowknife Dene, who's going to welcome us to their traditional lands and also introduce the drummers who will do a prayer song for us.
Thank you, everybody. For the drummers, is Bobby Dragies, David Dragies, Lee Roy, myself, Edward Sangris. Frederick, Vicina, Freddie,
and Ryder.
And
Ryder.
Ryder. I'd like to welcome each and every one of you to our traditional territory, which we call Chief Dragies Territory. It's within the Cajun region. A part of our land has been, significant for us as Dene. And as in our protocol, in our tradition, that anytime we commemorate something, we ask the Creator and our forefathers to look upon the event, so that they have a meaning and connected to the land. One of the many things that has been commemorated is, the one we're going to do today has brought, economic opportunities for First Nations and for the North, for the city of Yellowknife. And it's something that most people don't appreciate. But we have to do what is upon us to be thankful. And we always, as Dene, we're always thankful for the things that are happening in our land. And that's why we always try to walk the fine line as leaders between economic development and the environment. We want to benefit too, but we also want to leave something behind for a future generation to carry on their tradition and their culture. And I think one of the commemorate things today that we're going to do has brought that to our people. Without that, we wouldn't have any economic opportunities in the North. So I think it's something that we as Dene and the people of the North, should give notice to the people that do work on these roads, and some of them have suffered from it. It's something that hasn't been recognized too often in the North, especially in the North, where make things easier for communities, for people, for industry, and for government. So we'd like to, we're going to do a prayer song to open this event. Merci, Joe.
Thank you very much for that. It's, it certainly is an honor and a pleasure for Parks Canada to be welcomed to Yellowknife Dene's traditional territory. Now it's my pleasure to introduce to you the official party platform for this ceremony. I've already introduced Chief Sangris, Dr. Tom Andrews, who's the NWT's representative on the National Historic Sites and Monuments Board, is with us today, as well Mayor Mark Heyck of the City of Yellowknife, who has graciously offered the space and provided the stone to mount the plaque and done a lot of the work here to prepare the site. Thank you very much, Mark. I'd like to acknowledge also the guests that are here, come to celebrate the designation of the establishment of ice roads in the NWT by the Historic Sites and Monument Board of Canada. I should maybe share with you a little bit of the history of the Historic Sites and Monument Board of Canada. It was established in 1919, and the board provides informed and impartial advice to the Government of Canada on the commemoration of Canadian history. And in particular, this includes reviewing nominations of persons, places, and events that should be recognized as national historical significance. So there's a number of plaques that you've probably seen in many places throughout the Northwest Territories and throughout Canada designating events of national historical significance as well as persons and places. The board has members from every province and territory who generally are scholars or recognized experts in a number of fields, and that includes history, archaeology, anthropology, literature, etc. For nearly 100 years now, the recommendations have resulted in the designation of more than 2,000 persons, places, or events throughout Canada. These are items, of course, of national historical significance. They're persons and places and events that have marked our country's shared history, and they're commemorated by familiar bronze plaques that outline the contributions to the country. Sort of hope that anytime one of you see these plaques, you stop and take a moment to read them and to recognize the national significance and the really diversity of the history that our country has. I think now it's probably more appropriate that rather than me explain too much more of this, that I turn the mic over to Dr. Andrews in terms of a bit of a background to this particular designation. Tom?
Thank you very much. Merci. On behalf of the Historic Sites and Monuments Board of Canada and the Government of Canada, I would like to thank Chief Edward Sangris of the Yellowknives Dene First Nation for walking us to his traditional territory today. I would also like to thank His Worship Mark Heyck, Mayor of Yellowknife, for coming together to help us celebrate this historic commemoration. Today we are here to commemorate ice roads. This incredible northern engineering phenomenon is commonplace for us, but has labored in relative obscurity in the rest of Canada until it was pole vaulted to international fame and recognition with the TV show Ice Road Truckers. For the record, I want to clarify that this designation was proposed and accepted by the Historic Sites and Monuments Board of Canada in the year 2000, a full 7 years before the TV show hit the airwaves on June 2007. This ceremony is overdue and a well-deserved recognition for the role ice roads have played in our collective Canadian history. Today we are here to celebrate the contribution to the development of the Northwest Territories provided by the pioneers of ice road building technology. We in the NWT have relied on them for supplying our communities, building industry infrastructure, and connecting our people during long, cold, dark winter months. Young people today will not remember the cat trains of the 1940s, but there are many elders who can still share their stories of the long, slow hauls of the many sleds being pulled by a caterpillar and the benefits they brought to communities and work sites when they arrived. One of the biggest impacts of these roads was with the petroleum and mining industries in Canada's north. Without the ice roads to bring in the supplies and equipment, it would not have been economically feasible to open many northern mines that became important contributors to the Canadian economy. But ice roads are not confined to resource extraction. Ice roads have also made life easier for northerners by lowering the cost of importing necessities while providing increased access during the winter months. They form an important part of our northern social fabric, tying together families and communities. We stand here at the spot where the ice road runs to the community of Dettah. In the Mackenzie Valley, ice roads connect communities like Toledo and Wrigley to the all-weather highway system. In the Beaufort Delta region, ice roads have tied Fort McPherson and Tuck to the Dempster Highway. In Fort Smith, an ice road travels south through Wood Buffalo National Park, offering an alternative route for tourists, adventurers, and other travelers. As we grew up here in the north, we have all heard stories about construction and maintenance of ice roads, and as a result, we are well versed in their dangers, but also the etiquette required for their safe use. The many people over the years who have built and rebuilt these routes each new season are the unsung heroes of these great roads. The early roads to Discovery and Tundra Mines, the Echo Bay or Tibbet to Contoito Road, the road to Terramine are all memorable examples. It's because of their commitment and skills that we have this history to celebrate today. We should commemorate these road engineers as well for the roads they build and continue to build, as they have contributed significantly to a strong northern history and economy. The Canadian government is proud of the role these innovative and practical ice roads have played in forging our northern Canadian identity. Their legacy represents an enduring and significant historical presence in the Northwest Territories. That is why today we are honoring this event and the contributions made to the development of Canada with this Historic Sites and Monuments Board of Canada plaque. The plaque commemorates the establishment of ice roads in the Northwest Territories as an event of national historic significance. Canada's national historic designations enable us to experience our rich history and heritage in a special way. I'm very proud to be able to share in the celebration of this event, which has shaped our industry, our communities, and our country. Merci, Cho, merci, thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Andrew. I think it's safe to say that the Northwest Territories is very fortunate to have Dr. Andrew on the Historic Sites and Monument Board as a passionate advocate for Northern history, which benefits us all in terms of designations like this one. I think now I'd like to welcome His Worship Mark Heyck to the podium to talk a bit about.
Thank you. Thanks for coming up. Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. I'd like to just take a moment to recognize a few people who have joined us here today. First off, my colleague and friend, Chief Sangris from Dettah, as well as the other visitors that we have here from Dettah, thank you for coming today. I would also like to acknowledge that we find ourselves on Chief Tregee's territory, and we're grateful to be allowed to be here today. I'd also like to acknowledge some of the members of the City's Heritage Committee, current and former. We have former members Yvonne Quick and Chuck Tolley, I saw earlier. Chuck may have yet to leave. And Tom Andrews, I believe, was also on the Heritage Committee many years ago. And Dave Kellett is a current member of the Heritage Committee. And I mention the Heritage Committee because we are here to recognize the historical importance of ice roads to not only Yellowknife, but all of the Northwest Territories. And our city's Heritage Committee has for decades now been working on a plaquing program to recognize those important historical points of interest throughout our community and to share information about those points of interest. So several months ago when Tom contacted us about the possibility of installing a plaque recognizing the importance of ice roads somewhere in Yellowknife, we were very, very pleased to assist in whatever way we could, and I'd like to recognize our Director of Community Services, Grant White, and Grant's department was very helpful, I understand, in locating the big rock on which we've mounted the plaque, and in identifying a location, and I think we found the perfect spot right next to the entry to the Dettah Ice Road, the ice road that connects us with our friends and neighbors in Dettah. So we're very, very pleased to be able to help. I want to thank the Historic Sites and Monuments Board of Canada and Parks Canada for undertaking this work to create this plaque and to have it installed here in Yellowknife. And I'm grateful that you've all joined us here today to unveil the plaque and take part in this ceremony. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mayor Heyck. I must say it's been an absolute pleasure to work with Mark and his team in terms of setting this up, finding a site. The work done by Mark's staff has been great in terms of facilitating this and making this move fast and allow us to be here today. I think now, if I could, I'd like to invite the members of the platform party over to the plaque for the unveiling. And I know Mayor, Chief Sangris had to leave to head over to Dettah, I think.
Yeah, he was Dettah by three,
he was running
so,
on
yeah.
a short time, so.
Yeah. If we had the ice road, he could have stuck around a little longer.
Yeah. 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 You two gentlemen, go ahead. And I think now to close out the ceremony, we're going to have a closing prayer and from the drummers, I think. I hope you guys folks are aware of that.
Oh.